Hi, my name's Katie Robson and this is my vlog, and I will be discussing my buy behaviour and why I do or don't make certain purchases. So the first purchase I'm going to be talking about is a routine problem solving purchase. These purchases are regular and habitual. They are the type of purchases you physically need. You don't even think about when you buy them. They're often quite impulsive and are often low risk, and they aren't expensive and don't involve any commitment. My example of one of these purchases is a McDonald's. A McDonald's is the type of thing I would buy if I was out either at uni or I was out shopping and I realised I was really hungry. It was something I'd be buying then. They are always quick, easy. You can go in, you can order your food on a big screen. You don't have to queue and wait for people. And it's cheap, it's quick. I know what to expect from McDonald's. I know I like the food, and there's no commitment when you buy it. It's not expensive. You don't worry about, should I have bought that, should I have not? And I know that I'll enjoy it. My next purchase I'm going to discuss is a limited problem solving purchase. These kind of purchases involve more of a decision making process. They're slightly more expensive, but still involve limited risk and involvement. My example of a limited problem solving purchase is this new jacket that I bought. It was £20 and it was from Primark. I did think about whether or not to buy this. I tried it on in Newcastle, I tried it on in Leeds. I was not sure whether I wanted it. However, I saw a very similar product in Zara and Topshop, which was almost identical but was actually £70. So this was only £20, and then in my eyes that was a bargain. So I decided I definitely needed it. It's very fluffy and very comfy, so it was a great purchase and I was very happy. Finally, the last buying situation there is an extended problem solving purchase. This is a purchase that is much more frequent and involves long-term commitment and a long decision making process. These purchases are often very expensive and involve serious investment of time and effort. They are also regarded as high risk. It's not something you just do randomly. You know, people really do think about these purchases. Some people would regard houses as these kind of purchases. However, my example is quite different. Example is Rosie. This is our 3-month-old Labrador. We bought her from a breeder in Yorkshire and she cost £850. We searched for weeks online looking at lots of different breeders, and we also had to consider what type of dog we wanted and what would best fit our family. Obviously, there's lots of commitment that comes with having a puppy. There's lots of additional costs such as dog food, toys, bedding, medication. So we chose to purchase a care plan that's an ongoing service and covers her for all her checkups and vaccinations. We also have pet insurance, which is £34 a month and covers her for any injuries or illnesses.
So my next purchase I'm going to talk about is a new pair of jeans I bought from Zara. This links to Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Maslow believed that we had physical needs, safety needs, belonging needs, esteem needs, and self-actualization. So regarding my jeans I bought, I think I made this purchase to fulfill my belongingness needs. Since moving to Leeds, I've noticed a lot of people wear mum jeans. Back home in Bolton, this wasn't really something I'd usually wear, and I definitely wouldn't buy them. But now I live in Leeds, I wanted to fit into the social culture and wanted to feel like I was part of a society. So by buying these jeans, it's helped me to feel like I fit in much better. Many clothing shops sell mum jeans, including Topshop, River Island and H&M. However, they are much more expensive, and in Topshop they're actually around £46 a pair. The ones I got from Zara were actually in the sale and cost £12.99, and considering I wasn't 100% on them, it made it a lot more affordable, and since wearing them I felt like I fit in a lot more. Social media and the internet has a massive impact on what purchases I make, and sometimes they are positive and negative. An example of when bad publicity has affected where I shop is with Pret A Manager. In the news there has been many articles on how Pret mislabeled one of their food products which contained nuts and has caused a girl to die of anaphylactic shock. This has massively put me off shopping at Pret. I think their lack of attention to detail and them being so careless, it's made me definitely never want to buy food from there again. And I can imagine from all the bad publicity they have, because I have read about this in multiple different places, that people with allergies have most certainly been put off buying food from there. I wouldn't shop at Pret anymore, and I would be much more likely to go to their competitors, places like Starbucks and Costa, which I'm sure other people would be doing too. So my last purchase I'm going to talk about is my new eyeshadow palette by Morphe. The reason I bought this product is because on Instagram I've seen lots of celebrity makeup artists using them and giving it really good reviews. This is actually a form of celebrity endorsement, which is a marketing technique. When myself and other people see famous people using certain brands, it makes them want to buy it. This is because people look up to celebrities as types of heroes or idols, and because they want to be just like that celebrity by buying this product, which is also affordable and in my price range, it makes me feel closer to them and more like them.
Thank you very much for watching my vlog.